Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to compound interest in Microsoft Excel. So we will be going over two methods today. The first method we have right here is the compound interest formula. And then our second example over here is the Excel FV function.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So first, the compound interest formula. I put the formula over here and the variables that make up the formula to hopefully help you better understand what's going on. So we are going to calculate the future value of the investment that includes the interest, where this P here is the principal amount, the R is the annual interest rate, the N is the number of times that the interest will be compounded, and the T is the time that the money is invested for in years. So first, in our equation, let's type the equal sign over here in cell A2. And let's say our principal is $10,000. So if I'm following my formula right here in D1, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to type the multiplication sign, which is right above the 8 key usually on your keyboard. So if I just hold down shift and type that asterisk. And then in parentheses, I'm going to put 1, because there's a 1 in the equation, plus what my rate is going to be. So let's say that my rate is 0.065, and that's my annual interest rate in decimal form. And then if I'm following my equation, I'm going to type the divided by sign. And then what is my N going to be? Well, my N is the number of times that the interest is going to be compounded. So let's just say our interest is compounded twice. And then I'm going to close my parentheses because I am following my formula. Next, I'm going to raise this to a power. And in order to raise to a power, I'm going to hold down shift and the 6 key with that little caret character, because that's how you tell Excel that you're going to be using an exponent. And then I'm going to put this in parentheses. What is my N? Well, I already decided that my N is 2. And then I'm going to put the multiplication sign again. And then now I need to enter a value for T. And let's just say that T is 3 years. Then I'm going to hold down shift and end my parentheses and hit enter. Over here, I can see I have $12,115.47. So that means after I put in $10,000 with an interest rate of 0.065 that gets compounded twice over 3 years, my $10,000 is going to turn into this number right here. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So for our next example, let's try the Excel FV formula. And first, let's go over some of the variables in the FV formula. So right here, I'm going to be looking for a rate, which is the interest rate per period. And then my next argument is going to be the N per, which is the total number of payment periods in the annuity. And then my payment is going to be the payment made each period. This has to be a constant payment. It can't be a variable payment. And then we have the PV, or the present value. And then we have the type. And here we're going to use 0 or 1 to indicate when payments are due. We're going to use a 0 if the amount is being added to the investment at the end of the period, or a 1 if the amount is being added to the investment at the beginning of the period. And this is optional. You don't have to use this argument. So over here in A2, I'm going to type equals FV with a left parenthesis. So my first argument here is the rate. And in this case, let's say our rate is 0.065 divided by 2. And then I'm going to type a comma. And the next argument I'm going to be prompted for is the N per. So in this case, this is going to be 3 times 2, because we're using 3 years from our previous example times 2 for how many times we are going to pay out in that period. And then I'm going to type a comma. And my next argument is PMT. So in this case, we're going to put a 0 because no deposits have been made in between the period. And then I'm going to type a comma, and my next argument is going to be present value. So my present value before was $10,000, but in this case, we just need to make it a negative to show it as cash outflow. And I'm not going to use an optional argument for the type. So I'm going to close my parentheses and hit enter. And I can see here that I am getting the same result as I got over here on my first tab for my compounded interest formula. So hopefully that helps you to see two different ways that you can compound interest in Microsoft Excel. If you would like further explanation on either of these formulas, I will include the link to our blog in the description below on YouTube, so feel free to visit there. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.